good afternoon. I am not Dr. Stanley Workman, director of music at Second Presbyterian Church, who you were probably expecting to hear. Instead, I am Allison Bauer, pastor of Second Presbyterian Church. Usually you hear my voice at the end of the service, but today I am here to introduce this week's Sunday Vespers hymn sing program. We thought it would be fun to flash back all the way to our very first program from Sunday, May 17th, a service that focused on the hymns of Fanny Crosby, one of the most beloved hymn writers of all time. We are grateful to all those who have been listening to us from the very beginning. And we are also glad to know that we've picked up some other listeners along the way. So thank you for tuning in each week on WIOI for this service. We continue to pray that this ministry of music would soothe your souls during these anxious times, and that hopefully it gives you something to look forward to each week. And now, without further ado, here is Dr. Stanley Workman.
Good afternoon, and welcome to this Sunday afternoon Vesper Hymn Sing. I'm Dr. Stan Workman, and I am joined by my friend Justin Wiget at the piano, and we are happy to present to you this afternoon of hymns. We are especially going to focus today on the hymns of Fanny Crosby, the 19th century hymn writer who was blind from the age of 6 months. Nevertheless, her hymn texts were staples for the music of the most prominent gospel hymn writers. The first hymn we're going to present today is Praise Him, Praise Him, one of my favorite Sunday school songs. And I imagine, Justin, you might have sung it in your EUB Sunday school as well. Justin and I both come from the EUB tradition. Rescue the Perishing is one of Fanny Crosby's most famous hymns. She was inspired to write it after she met the men who were housed in a New York City mission. She was concerned about their spiritual well-being and earnestly pleaded with the men that if there was someone who had wandered from his mother's home and teaching, to please come and see her at the end of the service. A young man came up to Crosby and said that he would like to see his mother in heaven, but according to the way he was living his life, he was convinced it was not possible. After ardent prayer with Crosby and everyone attending the service, he accepted God's justifying grace. That night, when Fanny Crosby went home, she wrote the words, "Rescue the Perishing." Pass Me Not, O Gentle Savior, was one of the first hymns by Fanny Crosby to gain worldwide fame. She was visiting a prison And one of the prisoners cried out, "Good Lord, do not pass me by." Following her friend's suggestion, she wrote a hymn that evening incorporating the line, "Pass me not, O gentle Savior." "Jesus, keep me near the cross" is one of the most remarkable texts of Crosby, where she combines vivid imagery and powerful biblical and evangelical metaphors, especially amazing for someone who was blind from early childhood.
So
I am thine, O Lord. This hymn is one of the many collaborations between Crosby and composer William Doan. One evening, she and Doan talked at length about the nearness of God in their lives. When Fanny went to her room, her mind and heart were flooded with ideas from their conversation. Before she went to sleep, the lines of I am thine, O Lord, were in her mind. The next morning, she recited the words to Doan, who wrote down the stanzas and compose the tune. All the Way My Savior Leads Me was written when Fanny Crosby found herself in a particular crisis, a financial one, and one which she did not know how she could solve. She prayed about it, and a few minutes later, a stranger came to her door and handed her the exact amount of money that she needed. She was amazed at the Lord's marvelous answer to her simple prayer. I have no way of accounting for this, she wrote, except to believe that God, in answer to my prayer, put it into the heart of this good man to bring the money. My first thought was, it is so wonderful the way the Lord leads me. Blessed Assurance is an example of a hymn in which the tune preceded the verse. Her good friend and hymn writer, Phoebe Knapp, played the melody for Fanny Crosby and asked, "What does the melody say to you?" Crosby replied that the tune said, "Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine," and it is one of her most beloved hymns.
Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of God.
To God Be the Glory is one of Fanny Crosby's most famous hymns. Interestingly enough, it fell out of popularity in the late 19th century, but was revived in the Great British Revivals by Dwight Moody and Ira Sankey, and then traveled to the United States again in the revivals of Billy Graham Crusades.
And now, as a special bonus, here's a preview of a new song that you'll hear in next week's Sunday Vespers Hymn Sing.
Sins fall away.
Thanks for tuning in to another Vespers Hymn Sing service sponsored by Second Presbyterian Church. We hope you enjoyed our service today, and if you have requests of hymns that you would like to hear, or if you would like to sponsor one of these radio broadcasts, please contact the church at 740-353-4159. That's 740-353-4159. Again, thanks for listening, and we'll see you back here at 6 o'clock on WIOI.